Hello students, good afternoon. How are you? How do you feel nowadays at your homes? I think all arrangement the holidays very nicely. Okay, dear students, as you know, study is first. Okay, so let's start learning some important facts regarding the topic comprehensive passages. As you know, the comprehensive passages play a very important role in obtaining the marks in this class 12th question paper. So I think we should learn some important facts related to this topic. So the topic is here. The topic is here, comprehensive passages. PREHENSION, comprehensive passages. Okay, comprehension passages. Basic rules to write the answers correctly. Basic rules to write the answers correctly. Rule number first. Read the question heading thoroughly before answering it. Rule number second. Select the subject from the heading and start the answer with it. Rule number three. Answer the question in the same tense as used in the heading. Keep the word limit in 15 to 20 words, excluding the question headings. Question words in we should check it out whether the question heading is written in the present tense or in the past tense. If the question heading is not selected, if the question heading is not selected and not observed by you very carefully, it can't be possible for you that you can answer the question very correctly and logically. Third, answer the question in the same tense as used in the heading. If you don't use the same tense form, just imagine, for example, the question heading is given in the present tense, so your answer should also be in the present tense. If the question heading is in the past tense, your answer should be written in the past tense. Don't follow the language of the passage. Sometimes students make a number of mistakes that they follow the language of the passage. It is not correct. We should never follow it. We should always go with the question heading if you want to answer the question very correctly. And the next fourth rule is keep the word limit in 15 to 20 words. It is estimated, approximate word limit. It is not fully sure and certain that you can write down the answer in 15 to 20 words. I never suggest it. But most of the answers in them are written in such words, 15 to 20 words. Sometimes students extend the word limit so long, and it also makes the examiner totally irritated and forces him to deduct the marks. So these are the four steps are to be followed by you. First of all, the question heading is to be read by you very thoroughly and find it out what is the subject area in the question heading. If you don't search for the question subject in the question heading, it cannot be possible for you to write down the answer very correctly. So now I would like to write here only two or three most important formations regarding answering the questions. Structure of formation. Structure of answering the questions. Structure first, question, and also write it here. Structure first, question, and then answer. For instance, if the question heading is in this form, the second formation, the second structure, the second point will be here. The third is here. A number of questions are set up, are formed under these three formations. The first two formations relate to the simple present tense, and the third, the last C, it relates to the simple past tense. When you find any question as written in the simple present tense, and you see here the use of the auxiliary verb does, so the answer is to be written here with the subject. First of all, you should use the subject, then the first form added with S or ES, and the remaining part of the question heading. Now it depends which words will be used while answering the question. So this will be discussed by us in the next step, next structure. First of all, you have to see how to start the answer. How to start the answer. The way of answering the question, the method of answering the question is to be adopted first. And the second point, the second step also Give us subject plus first form. Okay. When you find, when you see here the use of the helping verb do in any question heading, so now your answers will start here with the first form, with the subject, and after subject you will prepare the first form, the main verb. Okay. And when you see here the use of the helping verb did in any question heading, so now your answers will start here with the subject, and after subject you will use here the use of the second form and the remaining words as given in the question heading. The last fourth is here when you find any question starting with end of this word and any other helping verb like is, am, are, okay, has, have, was, were, okay, can, should, like this. So now your answer also should start with the same pattern. Here will be verb. Okay. So now how to start the answer? Answer is to be started with the subject. First of all, the subject is to be put here. Then the same helping verb is to be put here, placed here by us, helping verb, and then again the verb. What is the verb here? This the verb is also to be written by us here. Okay. So now it is to be checked by us. The next one is here, fifth one here. If the question start with any helping verb, direct questions, do and does, maybe, can or may, like this, and then the subject here, okay, and the verb here. So dear student, your answer will start with yes or no, and then the subject will be here. After subject, answer in affirmative form, helping verb or verb, or in negative sense, you will use write your answer, helping verb plus not and plus verb. Okay, like this. So now I tell you here, what is the structure number first? What does the structure number first say to us? According to the first structure, we have to check it out whether the question heading contains the helping verb does, or the helping verb do, or the helping verb did, or some other helping verb. If the question heading contains the helping verb does, so it means the question heading is in simple present tense. And do, if the question heading contains the helping verb do, it means the question heading is in simple present tense. And we will have to write our answer, as I already told you, using this pattern. Okay, the pattern is to be followed by you. After the subject, first form plus first form added with SOES here. After the subject, the first form of the main verb here. After the subject, we have to use here the second form. Okay, because the question heading in the simple past tense, and if we find any other helping verb, so then we will use here the helping verb just after the subject, and after the helping verb we will use the same verb as given in the question heading. Okay. So now I would like to give you some examples also. But the second structure is to be discussed first, then I will give you the examples. Okay? Structure number two. What does this structure number two, second, structure number second tell us? According to this structure number second, it is told to us that which word should be used, okay, to answer the questions. Nature of words to be used while answering the questions. Okay. So here the step one. If the question heading starts with the word why, okay, and you find here after why the helping verb, subject, okay, and warm hair? So answer is to be given. Subject is to be placed first. As I have already told you that we will start our answer with the subject. Okay, we will start our answer with the subject. Soon after the subject, we will put here whether the verb or helping verb. It depends on the question structure, question formation. So helping verb or verb as per the question heading. Now the remaining words as given in the question heading are to be used by us, written by us, and then we will write here the answer using the word because. Okay, the first word because, to show the reason. After because, subject, again the helping verb or verb. Okay, the second word is here in order to. Okay, this the word because is used to show the reason, to show reason, reason, and this the word in order to show the purpose, to show the purpose. After this we have to use here the first form of the main verb. The first word is this one, the second word is this one, the third word is here so that. So that, after so that we will use here subject and can or could plus first form. It is quite mandatory to all of us that when we use the conjunction so that, this the conjunction so that, so after using this the conjunction, it is quite mandatory to all of us that we will have to use whether the model can or the model could. It depends on the question formation. Okay, and the fourth one is here, and so that. So that is also used to show the purpose, for purpose. Okay, it is used to show the purpose, to show purpose, purpose, P-O-S-E. Okay, and the fifth one is here, due to. Due to, after the word due to, we use generally any noun or any other word. Okay, but we never use here the word. We never use here the verb here after due to. And the fifth word is here, because of. Because of. Similarly, after because of, we never use any verb. So these are precautions must be taken by you. So, my dear students, you must check it out whether the question starts with the word why, interrogative pronoun. If the question starts with this interrogative pronoun why, so we will have to use any one of these five words. What are these five words? Because. Because it is used to show the reason, and the second word is here, in order to is used to show the purpose, so that, this word so that is used to show the purpose, it, we can use whether in order to or so that, but if you use the word so that, so we will have to use the model can or could, okay, in the answer. And the next word is due to and because of, okay, the next word is here, step 2, how. When we find any question starting with how, so our answer is to be written under these formations. The answer is to be written by us with the subject, after subject helping verb or verb, and then our first formation will be here, okay, by plus first form plus me ing. Okay, this is the present participle form generally used by answering the questions which start with the word how. How or in what way? In what way? In what way? Sometimes we also use because and when also, but when we use because, so because is generally used when we have to differentiate and we have to put the similarity between any two things. So this the word is to be used by us, okay, for it, and in what way and how. And the second point is here, second formation is here, subject plus may helping verb or verb, okay, and then here the word because. We can also use here the word because, because plus may subject plus may first form. So never make such kind of mistake which can force the examiner to deduct the marks. So you should check it out whether the question starts with the interrogative pronoun how. If the question starts with the interrogative pronoun how, so you can use you should use these two formations. Generally, this the formation is used, but sometimes you can also use this the formation because we can use the word because also. So it all depends on the question heading. Because is generally used to show the difference and to show the similarity between any two objects. So I think these the rules will surely help you to answer the questions as circulated by the institution to your link. So I know that you will surely follow these all methods, all rules very carefully and will be totally aware of these all things. Okay, so dear students, kindly keep yourself fully connected to your studies and don't waste your time. This is the crucial period and complete the assignments as given to you by the institutions. Be smiling. Thanks a lot for joining me. Thank you.